guys, it's Kate, and today I just wanted to talk you through some of my favourite bath products. So I've got some Imperial Leather, some Happy Place Cosmetics, some Lush, some Tranquility, and some Bomb Cosmetics. I'm also going to show you quickly my shampoo and conditioner. So I usually always tend to go for Bedhead Fudge or Matrix. You can get it from Sally's. You can also get it from B&M now, and I bought it last month, honestly. I've recently brought the Bedhead Split End Amender Leave-In Conditioner because I've ran out of my Milkshake Leave-In Conditioner. It's the one which comes out like, well, it looks like whipped cream, but it's obviously not. And it smells like vanilla milkshake. It's absolutely lush. So first off, I'm going to start by showing you my Imperial Leather. So I have the mermaid ones. Absolutely love the smell of these. It says bursting with bubbles, Fijian, I don't know how to say that, water and lotus flower. And obviously they're both the same, just one's bath, bubble bath, and one is shower gel. The next one I have is the marshmallow one. This is quite old, so it does say new. And that says rich, creamy lather, smells delicious, sweet treats bath cream. And it smells honestly amazing. And the next one I got, which I just got today, is the cosmetic unicorn one. And it says cosmetic unicorn limited edition, moon and sparkle unicorn dust. And you'd think it'd have some sparkles in it with it saying that, but not that I've seen. I can't notice any glitter or sparkles at all. And then the next one I have in here is Sweet Strawberry Dream by Treacle Moon. And it says, I'm only here for a limited time. I have had this one quite a while. I've only just moved it in with my normal shower gels and bubble baths. And then the ones I like to use for a treat are my Lush ones. So I've got Snow Fairy here. I've had this one quite a while. And it says, for sparkles like there is no snow tomorrow, lather in a candy sweet sud that shimmers with a magic that comes once a year. But it has set, I've just slapped myself in the face of that, but it has settled the glitter. Does anyone remember that granny that brought it for her granddaughter? And all hell broke loose because it says, how to use. We don't need to tell you how to use a shower gel, do we? If you really don't know how, then we suggest to find someone you really like and invite them to the shower with you to demonstrate. But she kicked up a stink over that. The next one I have is American Cream. That has settled a tiny bit because I've had it quite a while. And this one says, cleansing fresh strawberries and uplifting fresh orange juice go together like rama lama lama, ka dinga da dinga dong. Smell fresh forever as shubop shubra yip da dib da boom. And to be honest, the thing I like about the Lush ones is the scents are so much sweeter and there. And they're a lot thicker and creamier. The next one I have is the Sleepy Shower Gel, Sleep Drift to Sleep. Sweet tonka counts the sheep, lavender shakes the dreamland tree, and from it falls sweet dreams for thee. I use this one and the cream, the lotion, when I have trouble sleeping. It does work. It is a godsend, to be honest. And the last shower gel I have from Lush is Ectoplasm, and it is well loved. But it's so hard to get out the top. This is why I don't reach for it that often. Because it's so hard to get out the top. It's such a struggle. It's not worth it half the time when I'm having a bad day. But it says shower scream for this one. When you're feeling a bit disembodied, tangerine and grapefruit oils will help you return to the land of the living. I also have their rub shower scrub. I've had that one a while. I do need to get using it. Next up is Happy Place Cosmetics. And I placed my first order before Christmas. So I have the mashup here. That's what it looks like. And then I have the Marie Shower Whip, or Shower and Bath Whip. So you can either use it on your body, lather it up and use it as like a soap. You can run it under the bit and a lump under the tap and use it as bubble bath. And you can also use it as shaving cream. And that reminds me of the Lush's American cream, to be honest. And then next one I have is Next Bay Delivery. And this is a foaming body scrub. And this is the same scent as Snow Fairy. They are really nice. I've placed an order for the January box. So I'm hoping that'll come and I like everything in it, fingers crossed. Next stuff I've got is just some bath bombs from Lush. So I've got the Cheery Christmas I haven't used yet. Luxury. So there's the Luxury Christmas Purge. I've got Think Pink Bath Bomb. Shooting for the Stars, which I haven't tried before either. Yellow Submarines, that's a bit of a fatality, he has been here a while. I think I'm going to use him today. Next I've got Marshmallow World, which I really do recommend. You can smell it through the Ziploc bag. It smells gorgeous, so sweet. I've got the Candy Mountain to try. Never tried that before. This one, I can't remember the name of it, but this bubble bar, if you love like Snow Fairy, similar scents to that, get it, it smells gorgeous. There's a lot of Jack soap in here. So he's got the North Polar Bear soap, and we've kept it in the greaseproof paper. The Honey Bear Massage Bar, which should have been called the Honey Massage Bear. I had the Snow Fairy cold press soap. We had quite a few Shooting for the Stars. There's one in the wrapper. And here's one that came in a gift set, so we didn't have the wrapping on. That one's a pink one. Feels quite soft in places though. I then got a Starlight Starbright bath melt to try. And World's Smallest Disco. I haven't tried that one before either. We've got a Rocket Science. And a red. So then I also have this one. I've got two from Tranquility in here. This is the Princess one with a soap on top. And I also got Jack the one with a rubber duck on top, the Hero. I then got in two soaps. So this one was from Tranquility and this one's a Bomb Cosmetics. Let me move those. And then if you've watched my previous videos, you'd have seen my mood unboxing the advent calendar. So I've still got a load of those left. They are nice, they're just a bit boring really. But I will get around to using it. And then these are two of the Home Bargains holographic bath bombs. They just smell clean. I won't really say there's anything to them. And I don't think they're actually going to be holographic or anything special when they get in the bath. I had this one from a bath bomb box. I haven't used it yet because it's coffee scented. So I'm just, I don't know why it's here. I need to give it to my nan to use because I won't use it, but it is here. And then I have one from Wilkinson's, which is Blueberry and Morello Cherry. I have two more from the Bomb Cosmetics. Let me get those in my hand. I have the Reindeer and the Santa Claus. Do they have proper names? Can't tell you even if it takes the Santa Claus and I've got a sticker on. The Reindeer one's called Dear Me. Didn't say what scent though. Is nice though. And then I have this, which won't be getting used because it is awful. But I think what I might do is when Jack's having a bath one day, is just chuck it in there with him as a bit of a ha ha. Because that glitter is awful on it, honest to God.